chance. Que Let's pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Help us to live with those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life, and strengthen this faith and hope in us all the days of our life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I'll now present the program over to whoever's going to direct the proceedings of the speakers. So that person will take from here. Thank you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, amen. Thandweni bingelela futhi. Gabeni lenkosi yethu Jesu Christu, amen. Amen. Imina uphathi wohlelo, I'm the program director for today. I'm going to speed us fast. Everyone that's going to come to the front, I just need to make sure you have a very short space of time. Our time is limited. And just two things I'd like to ask. We need to keep our masks on. We need to make sure that we keep sanitizing. There's sanitizers all around. And try and keep the distance, comfort, and then keep the distance where you can. Amen. The facilities are outside for those that need them when you need to go there. And then the program is going to move at a very fast pace. Amen. Amen. I just want to greet all the political leaders that we have in our space, all the leaders from the church that we have in our space, all protocol observed. Just want to welcome everyone. I want to greet the family. Family akhathanjekwayo li family akamitsing this chaba kaofela esinalusona mo, and everyone that is online, you are greeted in the mighty name of Jesus. My name is Nokolo Noxintwane. We will proceed with the program. We've already had an opening prayer. We've been blessed, and this service has already been ushered in the right places. I'm going to call first daughter of Sipho Joseph Tanjekwayo, who we are here to celebrate his life and lay him in his final home. If I can just call Jabu Tanjekwayo, if you can take your programs and stand with us and hum the necessary hum as she reads the life story of her father.
I don't know, is this thing working? Can they hear me? I'm gonna try to get through this without breaking down. The late Sipho Joseph Tanjekwayo was born in Lady Sabon on the 16th of December 1967.
Please, everyone, just rise on your feet, except for the family. Just hum a background for us as she reads. May you kindly.
The late Sipho Joseph Tanjekwayo was born in Lady Sabon on the 16th of December 1967. He was the last born of the late Mr. Norman and Mrs. Tanjagwai. He received his primary and secondary school education at St. Anne's Primary School in Atteridgeville, Wepatutsi Higher Primary and Hlanganani High School, both in Soshanguve. It was during his high school days that he started to be involved in political activism. While in school, he was detained by Maputotwana police for being a political activist. During his secondary school days, he used to sell various items and trains in the community to generate income, which he used to assist his family. This is where he harnessed his negotiation, entrepreneurial, and financial management skills. Regarding his tertiary education, he was initially selected to enroll in a pre-university program facilitated by Kanya College, USAID, and Indiana University, which enabled him to be accepted at Wits University. He obtained a Bachelor of Arts in Social Science degree at Wits University in 1995. Subsequently, he enrolled for a Master of Science in Development Planning in the same institution and successfully graduated in 1999. I was grade one, by the way. Additionally, he enrolled for several short courses to develop himself and ensure that he remained relevant as a competent leader in both the NGO and government sectors. Some of the development short courses were informal study tours, which he took him to various countries, that included Cuba. Sorry. In 1997 to June 1999, he worked as a researcher for International Development Research Center, which is a Canadian donor organization. In 1999, he worked as a researcher for the Social Dimension CC. Between 94 to December 96, he was an... I can't see anymore. Sorry, can you continue? I don't think I can continue.
Getting a hot copy.
Between 1994 and December 1996, he was an editorial board member for the Homeless Talk community newspaper. From 1999 to May 2000, he was the national director for the Impact Community Volunteers of South Africa. He then joined the National Department of Transport as deputy director for research and strategic support between June 2000 and June 2001. Then he progressed to join the Gauteng Department of Agriculture, Conservation and Environment. Now the Gauteng Department of Agriculture and Rural Development as the Deputy Director of Public Participation and Awareness, and later became the Deputy Director for Stakeholder Engagement. He was promoted to be the Director of Stakeholder Engagement in 2006 to Chief Director of Director of Communications from October 2000 until 2009. From 2010 until his last days, he worked for the Gauteng Department of Community Safety. He started as a Chief Director for the Social Crime Prevention and Community Police Relations until August 2019, when he then took a role of a Chief Director for Corporate Support Services. Since March 2020 until he passed on, he was the Acting Head of Department, reporting to the MSC Faith Mazibuko. Over and above his functions as the acting HOD, he spearheaded the COVID-19 compliance work streams of the Gauteng Provincial Command Council. He met his untimely death on Wednesday, 2008-2021, due to COVID-19 related complications. He is survived by his loving wife, Tiara, five children, Jabu, Honze, Sechaba, Mbali, and Liano, his sister Amanda, nephews, nieces, and a granddaughter. Sipho, or Chief, as he was affectionately called by those who knew him, was a dedicated father, a loving husband, and a family man. He was a critical thinker and an optimist who believed in people, a visionary, comforter, evidently a selfless servant. He was a leader who had an ability to pull people together at all levels. He had a good heart and deep respect for everyone, irrespective of their status. Lala ngoxolo, Malinga Thanjekwayo, Mkhuzi. Wendlunkulu. Lodala aqakathise abeke phansi ngenkaba. Angedlulisa phesengo gabawufuthe oh my god, damn. Kabonina. And the place of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. Philippines. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, John. Akanayo incha piso. Akanayo inkhiso. Uya siza ngeqiniso uno thando aka nayo incha piso aka nayo aka nayo
I believe that was evident of the support that they will continue to have for each other when the big sister and there's a brother comes in. Babambisane empilweni kuko konke kunzima njengoba sibabonile bebambisana manje. Just want to umalume Jabu already. We go asitshele
etumela bana bantate ba kenite empele amodimo o re ruise molemo sa afele a o mohau wa modimo ye kwetsae ye kaka ke a le dumedisa nyane bingelela Mujabu Thanjekwayo Sipho mntwana ka ba mina mntwana ka ba bomkhulu silahlekelwe be family ka Thanjekwayo ne family ka Metsing na makholiki wakhe na ma friends ngibonga uNkulunkulu la ngiphuma khona kufika la eOakland Park ngibonga no program director anginike ispace kuthi uNkulunkulu ngizohlanganisa amazwi ngizokukhuluma isiZulu nesiSwana ngoba those families yisuthu nesiSwana but mina ngizokhuluma isiZulu
uSipho
ngimazi kudala basahlala eBokonot before Soshanguve nesihlala sonke le ebe amuvela to Soshanguve ngilahlekelwe intizwami ibuhlungu ngoba
Just kill me because you can hear everything.
City, Sibizana ngamagama ati Java ngithi city. Nesixoxa always ati awufuna kuza emuzini wami fanele ngufakele ilocation. Ngathi bro, amafoni wenu lanka yangihlupa. Ngiphethe ipopotane. So, hey, ngilahlekela Austiego, Awusamanda. Abantwana ba delayed. Says Gwen. Now says Amanda. Ningalahlani nibambane nabantwana bakaSipho esu Sipho nokuyipilara sili itu bambana umoya muphathi I can't talk again ngiyabonga
I would like to apologize. The one that's not on the program is not written there. Please introduce yourself before you speak. Thank you, sir.
Reyahubo kamo rena kadine hotsohle tsa reku. Acknowledge the Holy Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and the God, the Holy Spirit. Amen. I acknowledge you, Muruti. I acknowledge the family, Yahametsing, Yatanjekwayo, Nakalibito Kimweti Mwalusi. I'm standing in the space, Sandate Tiny Metsing, who has not been able to be here yet. It is a sad moment indeed. To perform a task so huge about a person so huge in life. It is indeed very sad that a person who's done so much in life can only have such a few bidding him farewell as a result of the circumstances under which we live right now. Be that as it may, we give it all unto the Lord. He determines our fate. Ours is simply to comply. Sipho is my niece, is my nephew, in the sense that he's married to my niece, Diego. Diego's mother is my elder sister. I come just after her. And we've lived together as the family. Lesipho, his house has been our home, all of us. We needed not to make any appointment. Indeed, a person's person, a people's person, very soft-hearted, very beautiful spirit, a very great soul, very humble, yet so sharp-minded. It is said that I've got to stand here and bid him farewell, but I find pride in that because we are laying a giant to rest. Mosebetsi wa hae o phethile. Diego, my baby girl, the pain is immeasurable, but time is therapeutic. In all things that happen, I know for sure God will give you the strength to carry on with the legacy your husband and yourself had set up to do. These children are your responsibility, and I stand here as a representative of the family that we will stand by your side and give you all the support. There's been such a great bond between ourselves and the Tanjekwayos, and we shall keep that going on. What was started shall never end. May his soul rest in peace, and God bless you.
Le kono tu le morena ti Ibeo bophilo baka matso
kopamisa aha re atumela atla kopile
ibeo bophilo baka matso aha Jesu.
Wait for my audio for a second there. The sister to the loving wife, Diego Tanjewayo, is going to read us the words that were penned from the heart of Diego that she's unable to read herself or say herself today. She'll take us through the heart journey of where Diego is right now. Maikutla hai, limlayotsa batla go tsho. Lebitsola hai ke Ostapi, Tis the Tis, Matapelo Ntanzi. God bless you.
I greet you all in the wonderful mercy name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. This is a message to my husband from Diego. I almost didn't write this letter because of the pain that pierced my heart when I realized that I will never see you nor talk to you again. Tanje Gwayo, you truly broke my heart. I never in my wildest dreams thought that you would leave me so soon. My heart also fills with gratitude, knowing that God loved me so much that he granted me 7 wonderful years with the love of my life. I want to thank you for loving me. Thank you for leaving me with a beautiful family. Thank you for making me a mother. Most of all, thank you for choosing me to be your wife. You may be gone, but you will never be forgotten. I'm struggling with the reality that you are no more. I do not understand why this is happening. I feel lost and lonely without you, and I really miss you so, so much. Losing you is like the biggest test of my life. But heaven has definitely gained an angel. And this is the reason why I know that you were too good for this world. You may be gone, but you will never be forgotten. In 7 days, our son Liano will be turning 5. I do not know how I'll explain this to him, that you'll never be here for his birthday. This pain cuts deep. I'm not sure how the kids and I are going to get through this chapter. I trust that God will be with us through this journey. For you may be gone, but you will never be forgotten. I never believed in love at first sight, but from the moment our eyes locked, I knew you were a very special, or as you would put it, I was hit by lightning. From then on, I tried my best to never look at you again. You may be gone, but you will never be forgotten. I found comfort in knowing that we'll be together someday and can celebrate our wedding anniversary once more. And I also find comfort in knowing that the next time we meet, we will be at heaven's door. Because when I see you standing there, I won't cry anymore. I will just put my arms around you and kiss your smiling face. Then the pieces of my broken heart will fall back into place because our love was our bond, and even death could not break it. You may be gone, but you will never be forgotten. I promise to honor our life together by focusing on the joy we shared and being the best mother I can be to ensure your legacy lives on. Rest, my dear husband. You ran your race, and I will ensure that your legacy lives on. For you may be gone, but you will never be forgotten. I will find comfort in God's arms because I know he will never leave nor forsake me. Rest, my husband. Rest, Ntate Tanje Gwayo. Rest.
If I get tired along the way, he gives me power to press on. Jesus in me has never failed. To this fight, if I get tired along the way, he gives me power to this far. Never, never, never fail. Yet he has never failed. He has never failed yet. Jesus' love has never failed. He has never failed yet. There is one thing I know, yes I know, Jesus' love has never failed, he has never failed me yet, unto this far, never fail me yet, never fail me yet. He has never failed me yet. He has never failed me yet. Jesus' love. Jesus' love. He has never failed me yet. Yeah. Yeah. There is one thing. One thing I know, I know, I know, I know, I know. Everywhere. Everywhere I go, Jesus' love, he has never failed me yet, he has never failed me yet, he has never failed me yet. There is one thing I know, one thing I know, everywhere I go, everywhere I go. Jesus' love has never failed me yet. He has never failed me yet. He has never failed me yet. Never failed me yet. He has never failed. He has never failed.
We just saw loop video of his personal life, touching, moving. You can see that Sipho Tanjewayo was a man of memories. He believed in memories and leaving a lasting memory in every soul he touched, especially in his family. So he was not great outside these, only outside these walls, but we can see that even within his great visionary, a leader, a man of impact, a loving man, a man that was there daily, every minute, every milestone. I don't have the rights to speak of the fatherly nature that he had in him, that he exemplified in us. Yesterday, we heard it also from his place of work where he exemplified the same. We just want you to hear from the hearts of his children. They've written a snippet of them, and they want to say something about their dad. We'll start in order. Firstborn. Jabu will speak on behalf of Mbali. When the time comes, if she's strong enough, she'll speak for herself. Litabo, and then it'll be Liano and possibly the granddaughter. Let them go through. The leader of the family, child.
Okay, I will try this one more time.
One, two, yeah.
My dad and I think everybody knows this, we used to fight a lot. But this week made me realize that we're actually the same. Same personalities, same fighting spirit. I don't really know what to say, but there's one memory that keeps playing in my head every day. When I had just given birth to my daughter, and he came to hospital to see us. And when you walked in, he said, "Yo, you're so beautiful. You're so beautiful, even after giving birth." Then the doctor came in to do the necessary checks. And he's like, "No, I will hold my granddaughter." While the doctor was busy with me, I couldn't even concentrate on what the doctor was saying because he was singing to my daughter. He was dancing with her. And then I knew that they would have this amazing bond. And she truly, truly loved him more than anything. And he always used to say, because Liano used to like calling my name, and he always used to say, "Let's swap. You take Liano, I take Zaya." He has taught me a lot. I don't know what to say, because I'm lost for words. It's a very difficult time, but since I'm the oldest, I need to try to stay strong for the ones that come after me. Thank you for the support. Thank you for the love.
To my late father, a lot has been said about you, and I'm sure a lot will still be said about you. All I want to say is thank you. Thank you for raising me. Thank you for raising us. Your constant presence in our lives has played a huge role in determining who we are today. The love you have showed us is unmatched. A lot of people have been touched by your love because that's who you were. I truly believe that my life wouldn't have been the way it is without you. I love and miss you. I want to thank you for all the memories, the conversations, and all the advice you gave me. I love and appreciate everything you have done for me, and I will forever be grateful. Yes, we have lost you, but I know that we have gained a guardian angel, an angel who will forever be with us everywhere we are. Thank you.
I didn't prepare anything because I didn't know what to say, honestly. But then I want to say that I truly loved him. He was my superhero. I looked up to him, and I will miss him. This is going to be a difficult time, but I know he is with us wherever we are, and he loves us all. Yeah. Oh. Thank you.
Dumelang. I can prepare anything. I didn't know how to get Lobolela, but then Prasipo, oh, he was a nice father. Correct. Oh. He took care of us. He was always there. Thank you.
In loving memory of my dad, I wish I could see you one more time. Come walking through the door. But I know that's impossible. I know you can feel my tears and you don't want me to cry. Yet my heart is so broken because I can't understand why someone so precious had to die. I pray that God will give me the strength and somehow get me through as I struggle with the heartache that came when I lost you. I love you and I will miss you dearly until we meet again. Thank you.
Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name.
I love you, my grandfather. You're the best.
Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. You are the mighty warrior. Mighty warrior, you're great.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Spirit of the living God. We come to you, O Father, right now. O Lord, reign, Spirit of the living God. Reign in this place, O Jehovah. Reign in this place, O Jehovah. Do what only the multi-breasted God can do. Even right now, O Jehovah, we come to you, O Lord. We call on you, Abba Father. We say, Thy art worthy of all praise. Right now, Father God, let the angels, Father God, come. Let there be angelic traffic right now. Let every heart, my God, hear you, O Lord. Embrace us, O Lord. Embrace us with your touch. Hold us dear right now, Lord. We lift up the Tanjewaya family right now, Lord. Touch every soul, O Father. Release every chain. Release every bondage. Let your soul, Father God, let us hear from you, O Lord. The cries, our tears, they're falling unto your hands, O Father. Do what only you can. Spirit of the living God, our comfort. Spirit of the living God, our intercessor. Spirit of the living God, our way maker. Spirit of the living God, the only assurance we have. Spirit of the living God, the only assurance we have. We smell of this petro. Simaguwe manje baba. Sisipepeteka manje kulukumu. In this home, O Lord, online, O Father, move, Spirit of the living God. Be unlimited, O limitless God. Rich in places, be infinite, O Lord. Touch right now, Father. Touch right now, O Lord. Touch right now, O Lord. Like only you can, O Father. Jehovah, Jehovah, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah, Ramaset. Hallelujah, Spirit of the living God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We stand and we depend on you now.
Oh, yes.
We depend on you. We run to your tower, Father God. We are hidden in you, Father God. Hidden in you, oh Lord. Embrace everyone right now. Embrace everyone right now. Embrace everyone right now. Embrace everyone right now. You say you shall never leave us nor forsake us, O Father. You say yet we shall walk through the valley, O Father. You shall hold our hand. You say you are close to those who are brokenhearted. It is in this moment, O Jehovah, that we need you to move. Arise, O Jehovah, arise. Yes. Let the enemy of fear. Oh Jehovah, we call on you, Father God. Move, Spirit of the living God. Move, Spirit of the living God. Awehlulwa lutho wena simakade. Ungunguyo, ungumadide, ungumanqoba. Kuzinto zonke simakade. Move right now, oh Father. Move right now, oh Father. Move right now, oh Father. We trust and depend on you. Our assurance is in you. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Amen. Amen. Shall proceed for the sake of time. I'd like to ask Sipho Tanjewayo's friends to come forward. He'll take us through the life we know, the life we don't know, the life you never might have wanted to hear, dear, some of it. As a friend, as a brother to them, because none of the three that I'm calling forward calls him a friend, calls him, they all call him a brother. They all called him a brother.
Just wanna try.
I will just let them flow in the way that they need to flow. They know that in totality they have a limited amount of time. They'll be led by Mr. Andrew Matavate, and from there onwards each person will introduce themselves if they are speaking, or if Andrew is the one that is the strongest of them all to share something, we will see from them.
Thank you, Program Director. Greetings to everyone who's participating in this funeral service. of our late friend, our brother, Joseph Sipho Tanjagwayo. Program Director, Ndumelele Kere, all protocol observed. Rena, really friends, just Sipho. It has never crossed our mind. Hardly well, I for today, recovery, memo, retrovole laka, past tense, Kayena. Retro vida a farewell today. Lehayuale, we still can't believe that he's gone. But the truth is, the Bacchanier is gone. The truth is that the visionary, the great mind, the charismatic leader is no more. The truth is that the social activist has left us unexpectedly. The truth is that the humble servant of the people has left us to join his ancestors. As much as this is difficult for us, we solemnly accept the hore, all what happened ki ine ile plan ya Modimo e leng hore rena re ka se change. As his friend, we can only thank God for having made it possible for us to become friends of a man of Sipho's caliber. We can celebrate his life by pursuing some of the things that he wanted to pursue in life. That way we'll be honoring his legacy. Unfortunately, Sipho is not here today to tell us how much he learned from us as his friends. But we know that he always appreciated our inputs, our opinions, whenever we're discussing anything. But Rona, as his friends, we learned so much from him. From him, we learned about what is a true friendship. Sipho was the kind of a friend who will not be only your friend when you are with him. Even when you are not there, he will be your friend. If he can't see you, he'll always try to check you. That is what we learned from him. And he was the friend that you could trust because he was very honest. We also learned from him that as we are professionals now, as we are adults, we need to strike a balance between our professional life as well as our social life. Sipho was able to do that. He had time for work. He had time for his family. He had time for us as his friends. And we had fun. So that is very important for us, because if you can't be able to strike that balance, you'll always have problems. But other than that, we also learned from Sipho that we need to respect everyone, irrespective of people's status, irrespective of age or background. We also learned from Sipho that when you do good, do not expect praise. You need to derive your satisfaction from the fact that you have impacted positively on other people's lives. We also learned that having a good heart is more important than anything else. Sipho had a good heart. He donated his time. He donated money sometimes. He donated his skills to ensure that people progress in life. But we also learned from Sipho as his friend that you must not be fearful about what you do when it is right. We also learned that a great leader is about impact, respect, influence, and inspiration. That's all what Sipho was. Yesterday we were listening to his colleagues, and all what I'm talking about came out. He was not only the leader in his professional life, but he was also a leader amongst us. As his friends, we are committing to continue with some of his lessons, or the lessons we got from him, to continue to impact positively on other people's lives as part of honoring his legacy. To the wife of Sipho, Tiego, Bana Kaofela, with the entire family, we will never stop to be friends of this family. We will continue to pray that God gives you the necessary strength, the super strength, during these difficult times. The scriptures indicate to us that God promised that he will never leave nor forsake us. So put trust in him. Farewell, our best friend, Brur. Farewell, comrade. Farewell, the finest leader. You have gone so soon, but you'll never be forgotten. Your spirit will live on. May your beautiful soul repose in peace. I thank you.
Good morning, church, men and family, MEC. My name is Isaac Lesole. I've had the privilege of being with Sipho almost every day of his life before he passed on. I've seen him go through the struggles the last few days. I saw the battle that the wife had to undergo, pushing him to go to the hospital. He wouldn't succumb to any. I had the privilege of being around on the day and carried him to the hospital. But I don't want to talk about that. I want to talk to him. Because everybody's talking about him as if he is gone, and I want to speak to him while he's here today. I want to speak to you and say, Sipho, Siga, Msaipo, Mzababa, what a mess. What did you do? Do you see what we've done? The children? Friends? Young wife that you always boasted so much about. I heard you speak to Liano the last time when you walked out of the bedroom. And you said, Mfanaka ki waritika wena. Those are the last words he said to his son when he left the house. You've caused so much pain to us, Sipo. You've created a mess. But I appreciate you. And on behalf of these friends that are standing here, I can confidently say that it was a privilege to be around you. Unolisixayela when it comes to ujaiva. We tried privately and publicly uruta ujaiva uhluleile. I'm still disappointed. I saw your pictures utraya ujaiva komsebetsing. What a disgrace. And yet you thought you were the best dancer. What a shame. But I loved you with everything in me, and you know it. I can only pray at this moment that God receives your spirit, that God protects your children, that God protects your family. You've left so many people with confusion, especially those who depended on you. But we're not asking God questions. And we say, Lord, if it's your will, let it be done. Amen.
Yo. Dumela mba thomo dimo. Le kae? Le tla ka ke tebo go ntswane. Sipho was my brother. I've been with him for as long as I can remember. I'm going to censor myself. Because some of the things, if I were to go and speak them out loud, they might affect his pension fund payout. So I know there's dignitaries here. But first, let me start at the beginning. Sipho was a hard man. He was a hard man on himself, and he was hard on those that did not realize how much potential they had. When he was arrested for 8 months in Buputatswana. He used to tell me, and he used to be very angry about it. He said, they used to make them go naked and shower them with a hose pipe and then beat them up while they were naked. And he said, it's fine because in those days they had to beat them up for them to give them the truth that they wanted. But he said, you know, Teboho, sometimes they would beat us just for amusement. I hope when he goes to heaven, he is not on the same queue and the same department as Lucas Manyane Mangope, because Lucas Manyane Mangope is going to die another death. He loved Jabu. He loved Jabu so much. I say this because I remember the years that maybe Jabu does not remember when she was growing up. But I remember, and I saw how he raised her. And the things that they did. I remember he used to love to go to take her to the library. And Jabu would sit there going through the books, and he would just sit there watching her read. And as they grew up, I remember Sipo complaining. I said, you know what? In fact, we had to stop Jabu from... Yeah. And then Bali came. Bali came. It was almost like a second blessing to him. Bali came, and the son came, and he was very happy. And what he did, he says, you know what? In life, you have to make the memories yourself. Don't wait for occasions where you want to celebrate something. Just make an occasion. And he used to put them all in one car and just travel without necessarily planning the trip. They would go so far without necessarily planning the trip. I remember one day they went to a place where they had not booked accommodation, and they went into this dark place where there was this Chinese grandmaster meditating. And they were afraid to go in. Yeah. He loved his mother. There's nothing that Sipo did without first going to speak to his mother. When they got married and they had to give Diego a name, it was almost automatic that they blessed her with giving her Sipo's mother's name. So whenever you want to refer to Diego affectionately amongst the Tanjekwayo, they refer to her as Salome, which is Sipo's mother's name. Here's the funny thing about it. When we were still growing up, because we used to have dreadlocks. I know. We used to have dreadlocks way back. But then there was no Google, so we didn't know how to... The Jamaicans made dreadlocks. So we went through a whole ingredients. I remember first we started Coke. We used to wash our hair with Coke and not do anything to it. And it helped to make the hair hard, but ukase robalo unka coke umruring. Then we went to Mai, because somebody told us there was the egg yolk actually nourished the hair as well, and we believed it because they were not le shampoo la ya egg ya Colgate. Then we started putting eggs on our hair. Yeah. I don't know. Eventually, the dreadlocks came. I don't know. It was a mixture of coke and egg, or it was just. I could say. But eventually, we had dreadlocks. There's pictures of us with dreadlocks. We thank God for dreadlocks staying. Otherwise, who knows what would have put first on our hair. I move from moments to moments, and I don't want to be. I just want to show you that Sipo was just. Sipo nearly more to Sipo. Sipo worked with hobos, Go Hillbro. But he was also able to stand in the presence of presidents. He was also able to command respect among higher powers, Go SAPS. And Sipo didn't just volunteer. Sipo would tell you, call you, come to you and say, hey, Honali March ya JBV kai 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 kai. And he was very passionate about that. Whenever he found a moment or something was happening in the news that led us to speak about gender-based violence, Sipo will grab it with both hands and he will go on and on and on I remember with this thing that, you know what, men are dogs, etc., etc. He said, you know what, I remember he said this. He said, it's not that men are like dogs. Men are mostly like Coca-Cola bottles, Coca-Cola drink, in fact, because we let our situation shake us so much that, and we don't open it to rinse pressure. And what happens is the pressure almost comes out at a time and a place when it's not supposed to come out. Since we have so much anger inside, it says that's why our crime and our killings are so horrible, because we come from a past of killing and revenge, and we haven't yet loosened up the cap here, that Coke bottle. There's no nation in the world where men actually take out their anger on their women like South Africa does. And it has to be with this thing here. We've been fighting, we've been dying, we've been killing, but we never really had a moment to take out the pain and the anger that we have inside. And that's why something, whenever he spoke, and he always spoke humbly when he spoke about things of gender-based violence, you will see him with his head to the side, almost apologizing, almost. He said, we have to humble ourselves. Men have nothing to say as far as how women should react to the violence, as long as men do not have a way of taking out that anger, Bona. One of the saddest times when I've seen him, I don't have enough time. One of the saddest times when I've seen him, Sipho, was when he was still working with Ntate Musungutu, when he told me, please don't, we're not going to meet each other. Please don't come through, because there were people that wanted to kill him. Because you remember that time Musungutu was busy with the taxi associations. And it took some time for me not to see him. And it affected our relationship. I remember that we couldn't go out as we wanted to go out. And when we went out. When you went out, you call me. Tebogo, okay, kimokai. Are to allow Shabba Msadi come matlong? Munno mubiang when Shabba Msadi come matlong on Friday. Kiatla. Before I could even finish dressing, he was already at the gate. Yeah. Ake ne mo lao tola bo Isaac, bo Tebogo bo Lucky. Ne sheshe na ko. Mamningas wenda we anga figanga. It's ill, of course, you're black. But he said it in a funny way, not in a proud way or anything. That means, Mshumayel. Tipesa kubeke, ganda. Ha. My friend, I'm just on stage now, I'm performing like you always said. I'm performing. The pain is gonna start when the crowds leave. When the lights go off and the candles are blown off, and this house will try to be what it used to be when Sipho was here, and then it will found that, you know what, there's a missing piece. There's no smell of cigar here. There's no smell of cappuccino in the morning. Uskampa frisco. Agwerekidi kitchening. Mfeji cops. Sipho, my friend, we will wake up one day and the sun will not come out. The time will stand still. Farewell, my friend. Farewell. Kalebo.
Jesu amingi bambe gesandla gingashi emlilwe. Jesu amingi bambe gesandla gingashi. Jesu amingi bambe gesandla gingashi emlilwe. Kiziyo.
Hallelujah. We've heard from his friends. Nikibuta Tiaho Mavani Kirio or it's a king sipo. Why as I'm briefer? Horiton take Jotava to about over 30 every night. Kisati will appear over 10. Uzumile, that's throughout his journey, I kept saying to Tiaho, Kima Gaiva Mutu Otoboa. And utlo boa tore tella mo na nantela ho la re umzulu itse nka re go taxi rank, you know, ham sad how te bogo ke muzulu. So yeah, we will really miss him. We really will miss him. We're just going to swiftly move. We have about Moruti Arera. We have about 20-25 minutes for the next honorable speakers that will give us the life of Sipho in his work life, in his career, in the impact in the community and society at large. We'll keep it brief, we'll keep it moving as we honor his life and his career journey. I'm going to call forward the former HOD for Community Safety, who is currently the DG for DPSA, Umama Yoliswa Makasi. Amen.
Sanbonani.
Maybe I should take this off. Ikamalam Dinguyoli Swamakasi. I worked with Sipho at Community Safety for 4 years, from 2016 up until 2020 when I left the department. I just prepared a very short memories about Sipho, and I want to first greet the family. I spoke to his wife. And I checked with his wife, how is Sipho? I introduced myself, how is Sipho? Something is just saying I must check on him. Please, when you talk to him, please tell him that I was just checking, how is he doing? And the wife assured me that, no, he's fine, da-da-da-da-da, and that was it. I forgot until I got a message telling me that Sipho is no more, which was quite shocking. And it's quite an irony because Sipho has been, when I left a Community Safety, it was end of February 2020, and in March, COVID hit us very hard. And knowing the work that they do at Community Safety and still following them on social media and other platforms, it's an irony to me that Sipho, who was leading the battle around COVID in terms of preparing the organization, in terms of preparing the department, and ended up succumbing to the COVID himself. Sipho, when I came into the department, he really was one of those colleagues who worked with me and showed the ropes, because he knew the work better than me. And part of the key attributes I noted about him, Sipho is a very compassionate person. Literally, Sipho does what, you know, this thing of putting yourself into in somebody's shoes. He literally does it physically. And I mean, you heard colleagues speaking about how Sipho's heart was connected to junior employees and etc. at the office. Sipho was passionate. I have never met somebody who is so passionate about work, being a social activist, working in a very difficult environment of gender-based violence, and generally safety of our communities. And sometimes communities struggle to appreciate even interventions that you go and do in those communities. But Sipho was just one of those colleagues who never wanted to give up and was very passionate. Loving, you heard yesterday, respectful, you heard yesterday as well. I do want to talk about Sipho as a servant leader, because Usipho has been that leader, as I got to know him, who really is connected with the people. So he wants to know what the people are thinking, and he'll come to you and tell you, hey, HOD, let's be careful here. You know, the people, sometimes it gets annoying because things must be done, but you know what the staff are saying and what the people are saying. But he was indeed a servant leader, in my view. Like any good attributes, they have their downfalls. And one of Sipho's biggest downfall, and this worried me a lot, because when I arrived at Community Safety, Usipho was a chief director of social crime prevention. And then we had to move him, because we had a new structure approved, and we had to move him to corporate services. And I remember worrying that, how is Sipho going to do corporate services? Because corporate services is about compliance. Usipho is a social activist who can be employing people every day to come to the office, sometimes without even following processes. As long as people are having jobs, it's fine. But we had this chat with him, and I was just trying to check if he's really going to cope with this work. But he amazed me, actually. He did very well as a chief director of corporate services. So his heart was at the right place. His heart was with the people. I want to say the other thing about Sipho, the last thing I want to remember about Sipho is that Usipho, because he was responsible for social crime prevention programs, so he was responsible to mobilize people generally when we have events and other things. So we'll agree the target is 500 people. I remember one event we had with artists in a hotel in Centurion, St. George's. We had agreed the maximum is 500 people. When I arrive in the event, Jesus, there's like 1,300 people. So I'm like, Sipho, what are we going to do with this? Like, no, HOD, we've sorted everything. We've done this. I'm like, Sipho, you're going to go over your budget and we're going to have problems with the CFO. He's like, no, we'll manage the CFO later. So Sipho loved people. And I just want to say to the family as I wrap up that you have been blessed to have a husband and a father who is so present, who is so loving. Sipho never stopped talking about his wife. Sipho never stopped talking about his children, which showed me that he was a family man and he was very connected. And I do want to leave you with one or two verses that the first one for me is Revelation 21:4. It says, he will wipe every tear from their eyes. So you have to look up to God. And I could see when the kids were speaking and everybody that there is a connection with God that this family has. So you have to look up to God to wipe your tears. Bantwana ba kaSipho, nkosikazi kaSipho, ne family kaSipho at large. And Psalm 147:3 says, he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wound. So we are looking up to God to heal you and to bind your wounds as a family. I would like to say, may the soul of Sipho rest in peace and in power. Thank you very much.
Jason Ashwela Calvary Kali Bagala Tibi Sarona Iyo Iyo Calvary Iyo Calvary.
I just need to move quite quickly. The next speaker we're going to have is the former NEC for Community Safety, currently the Chair of Chairs for GPL, Mamsizayele Nkosi Malobane. Amen.
Sanbonani. Mangibonge ku program director
ithuba enginikezwe lona ngibulise kumndeni wakaThanje kwayo particularly unkosikazi ka comrade Usipho. I think for today I'll be free to call him comrade. I've never called him a comrade in a public platform, but today I would like to call him comrade Sipho. Ngibulise unkosikazi nabantwana, ngibulise kudadewabo kanye nabanye bomndeni. But I also want to, because sometimes we forget about other people who feel the pain when a loved one have passed on, it's his friends. The same pain that the family feels, nabangani bayayifila. So ngithanda ukuthi ngibulise nakubangani, ngibulise ku MEC Mazibuko, ngibulise ku MEC Mamabulo, ngibulise ku umama uyoliswa Makhasi, nawo wonke i-leadership ye community safety about my I'm sorry because I'm a little bit disturbed khona manje because I just received a call that says a friend of mine who's also a colleague Umamlindela Sindo have passed on. So these things happens, and when they do happen you think ukuthi umhlaba uphelile sisi. And I'm sure even abantwana bakhe as we speak, which is an hour ago, they feel the same. So ngithanda ukuthi ngithi kumndeni duduzekani kunkosikazi. Duduzeka sisi. You now have a new name called Umfelokazi. But ngiyajabula ukuthi uNkulunkulu unendlela zakhe zoku-intervena. Abantwana bakho don't have a new name zokuthi abantandani. You are still there to look after them. Please use the support that you get from his colleagues, from the family, from his friends. And sometimes the support will come from abantu bangacabanganga ukuthi izochamuka kubo. I've known Sipho since 2009 when I became the chair of community safety in the Gauteng legislature. And when I started knowing him and ngifuna ukwenza a confession, I actually bengumcaphukela, you know, because of a certain program called Hlayiseka. It was a school safety program. What happened ukuthi and the reason for ukuthi ngayijabuleli was because there was a double dipping on that program. The same reports that we were receiving in community safety, we were also getting those reports go Department of Education. So, and I actually thought that there was collusion between the two departments to actually give the report, up until I realized ukuthi the wrong was actually on the side of the Department of Education. But because we had so much fight no Sipho about, and ngaso sikhathi sibe senala madress lo ubhuti kade akhuluma ngawo. So when it comes, ngithi hey azin, tata your time, but ngicela ukuthi ungangitsheli ngehlayiseka. Please tell me about something else, but don't tell me about hlayiseka. And uSipho will just look at me and ignore my comments and then go and continue giving us a report about hlayiseka. And I've got this loud voice and intimidating voice, and of course the body and the look to intimidate about. And I thought uSipho will get intimidated and he'll just do it like this. Ngiyezwa comrade chairperson, then continues with his hlayiseka. And it went on until I requested him to come to my office azongichazela kahle ngale hlayiseka yakhona, because I see two reports, and I was also a member of another committee where the same words, you know, the same style of reporting. The only thing was the difference, the other one was colored when reporting, the other one was African, which was Sipho. Then he reported, then indicated to me the origin, etc., etc. Then until we agreed that when it comes to community safety, let's change it to school safety program as opposed to Hlayiseka, but also don't share your report with Department of Education before bringing it to us. So our relationship started then, and few weeks later, when the report was brought to us, it has changed from what it used to, from being Hlayiseka to something else. But what actually brought us more closer and me understanding uSipho was the death of the former National Commissioner of Police, Ucheki Silibe. I never knew that Sipho was so close to him. So we had a discussion. He phoned me amongst the first people that he communicated his death, and he came to my office and explained their relationship with Ucheki Silibe. We also had our time, because I'm sure you know Mfundisi, we also have challenges in our organization, time to gossip. You know, so we gossiped about some of these challenges that we are having in our organization and maybe how they can be resolved. But also the commitment was Uguti is not the kind of person oyegela easy, of which naming labantu laba abangayegeli easy. They also any cutting yangabana so for us in Osipo was when he was deployed a Kayale Temba HOD. It was the most difficult time that Sipho Yasekhaya Letemba. He loved the job that he was doing there. But then the kind of people that were there, actually, yo, MEC, you know, I make sure that any good level, what, go flow, ban, go, I love a fast lava, ban, amanga, yo. But I'm, you know, he was so scared of being associated with wrong thing, Ganwami, you know. So he will say, Nizoya la paya. The manager, the deputy director, the deputy, the assistant director is there just to make sure Guti, but I'm protector from Labantu Lava Abana Lukuza Abana Abana Manga. But interesting, he will say such serious things, Ngendela a soft, not Ngendela a rough, you know. His voice was always a voice of a person that was Anazumi, a person who was not boisterous. A person who know ukuthi omunye umuntu yini. Usipho, I'm sure obuningi bethu have taught us ukuthi umuntu ngabanye abantu. Sipho, hamba kahle mfowethu.
Siyabonga, Chair of Chairs. Gonna move swiftly to quite an important speaker as well. And I think before she comes forward, just to commend what the department has actually done, the Department of Community Safety, from the moment I came here on Wednesday when the news broke. They've been here every day, almost every hour. And we see them, we see it, we feel it. The love is evident, siyabonga. So, the current MEC for Gauteng Community Safety, the Honorable Mam Faith Mazibuko, azosho amazwi. Okuningi besekushilo emndenini directly efikile phakathi nezinsuku. So, ife bamfishane.
Ma. Nagi Bumbino Bata Sona Ma Bata Sona Tasona, tasona ki, ibu matasona ma, tasona ki, ibu matasona. Sona ki, mu matasona.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Disadvantage of funerals nowadays is that abantu bafaka ama mask, so you are not sure if they are singing. Zababona nalo kube nyakazisa ama shoulders ukuthi hayi bakhona. Thank you very much, program director. And ngibhekisa inhlonipho yami ku family yakathenje kwayo, all the relatives, the friends, the children, and all those that are related and are closer to Sipho Thanjekwayo. Let me acknowledge our chair of chairs, who was also the MEC who worked with Sipho from 2014 till 2019. And also let me acknowledge the DG, Yoliswa, who was also the HOD, and for almost 4 years working with Sipho. Let me acknowledge abafundisi. Let me acknowledge. Let me also acknowledge everyone who's on call, the HODs from other departments, colleagues, and all staff members of the Gauteng Provincial Government who are also following this service on other media platforms. Ladies and gentlemen, indeed, it is well with my soul. And today we are here to bury another chief director in the Department of Community Safety. Last year we buried Utumsane. Namhlanje we are burying Usipho Thanjekwayo. And it is very sad for all of us who have worked with this dedicated gentleman. It's God that gives, and it is God that determines the destiny for all of us. And when we are born, even our departure time is also determined. Family and friends and children, ngesiZulu siyaye sithi isitya esihle asidleli. That's Sipho for you. Him being a servant leader, him being a dedicated person when he was doing his work. He served in all the portfolios he was deployed to with diligence and commitment. He never failed nor faltered. When given responsibility, he will implement, and not toy-toy. A true public servant, unlike others who are just fellow travelers, who are just here to earn a salary and not committed to serving the people of Gauteng. Thanjekwayo, that's how I will call him, understood the mandate of the 6th administration under Premier Makhura. He understood what is meant by deliverology. Deliverology is the instructions to deliver. He understood that we are impatient. We want the citizens of Gauteng to live in a safer and a free Gauteng, free from crime and crime. He understood that as the Gauteng Provincial Government, we have a 10-pillar program of TMR, which is transformation, modernization, and reindustrialization. He understood that coupled with the TMR program, there is the GGT 2030, which stands for going Gauteng together. And that in it, we had to develop a Gauteng safety strategy that will encompass the 10 pillars of making Gauteng a safer place for its citizens, the women, the children, and hold the police accountable. Thanjekwayo was a versatile person who was also innovative, clearly proving that within the parameters of his work in the department, he was even able to find ways to make this department to be responsive to the needs of the community through the social crime prevention, which encompassed the Know Your Neighborhood campaign, the establishment of the community patrollers and functional CPFs, the establishments of all the sectors such as your women as safety promoters, men as safety promoters, the youth desks, including helping children in conflict with the law. And he used to take them to correctional services to show them ukuthi crime does not pay. Thanjekwayo was a very quiet somebody who always consulted when doing his work. He will not implement something without verifying if he can go ahead and implement. He steered the department even during difficult times of COVID-19. And you will remember that that's when Yoliswa left early in the year and Sipho, we had to throw him into the deep end. But because Bega Ingutu in this department, he understood that the work of this department, and he was able to swim and steer it. He came to the department during the time of former MEC, Kgabisi Motsokutu, and they were coming from the Department of Agriculture. His love and passion for his work made him a servant leader, very humble and respecting. Of course, they got a chance, like everyone will do, and want to do things his own way. And I will ask him, is that in the APP? And I will tell him, let him go if it's not in the APP, because we don't want to find ourselves in conflict with the AG or other structures that we're accountable to. When you said to him, jump, he will say how high. Indeed, we have lost the dedicated Z83 personal brigade in him. To have to take him when we still needed his services. It's not for us to judge, but to accept. Good night, Sipho. Ulale ngokuphumula. Remember, when you get to heaven, Comrade Mapiti and other comrades will be there singing struggle songs with you. And make sure that you build a strong branch of the ANC. You are gone from our sights, but never from our hearts. Family, heartfelt thoughts go out to you in this time of sorrow. And to the children, Baga Sipho, your father adored you. Unfortunately, you are going to have to grow up without him. May you be dedicated people like him, emulate him, and you will succeed in life. To the wife, Sithu Bambe Njalo Dade, awedwa kulobuhlungu kubo, kepha silahlekelwe sonke sibaningi. Kofa amaqhawe, kusala izibongo. May you rest in eternal peace, Sipho, and rise up in glory. And hopingly, when one day icilongo nalikhala, sizokubona nawe ubuyisela ama-dreadlocks akho obunawo, ucula kanye nabo bonke. Siyabonga kakhulu, program director, for allowing us space to come and bid this young man farewell. Ngithemba ukuthi ifamily izoduduzeka, abangani bazoduduzeka, nabo bonke abanye abazwise ubuhlungu bazoxola ngenxa yokuthi siyayisithi masithandaza, sithi sixolele izono zethu njengoba nathi sibaxolele abasona. Bona izwe la kokwethu uqangisimo nozalo ute usisele. Thank you very much.
Reign, Jesus, reign. Reign, Jesus, reign.
Siyabonga, Honorable Mam Faith Mazibuko, the MEC for Gauteng Community Safety. Ngamazo sishiye nawo manje. We're going to hear a sermon and a word of God from the man of God, the mouthpiece of God. Okwamanje sizothola a worship song from our worship leader for today, uSisanda. Siyabonga kakhulu. Umungasinikeza worship song so that our hearts will be prepared for imbewu ezotshalwa uSimakade manje eyizwi lakhe ezimpilweni zethu.
Rain, Jesus, rain.
Noma ungeza ngapha Jesus.
Rain, Jesus, rain. King of Zion, Lion of Judah. Jordan, Lion of Judah, reign, 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 Jesus. You're the King of Zion, King of Zion, Lion of Judah, Lion of Judah, reign, reign, Jesus. King of Zion, King of Zion, Lion of Judah, Lion of Judah.
Chico, I am calling a listen. I am calling on Jungle. Long a ling on his son away. Long a ling on his son away. I can't get on I can't. I can't conjure away. I can't call in a Nisa now. Pagati Wabo Tuko.
Thank you very much. Let me just begin by acknowledging the MEC, Faith Mazibuko, and the former MEC, Sizakele, and all protocols observed. And I trust also just to appreciate the MEC for her work taking us through this service. And I would like to just express my special, special condolences to the family and the children in particular. I may not know all of you, but I certainly heard of you at one point or the other. I know the young active one, this young man here, the one that sits right out behind her mom. I know she used to jump off roofs, from the roofs and jumps down. When we were here, in her dad will always say Mbali. I think that's her name, eh? So I was here, and there's something very particular about the deceased, I must say. This podium is very special. I think I've I seem only to come here when I must come and appreciate a ceremony, either of blessing wedding rings or coming for something totally different. So this is a special place where we're standing here today to do this service. I'm also very confident that, you know, one thing I remember very clearly of Sipho, which was very interesting. My son had taken a liking into him. My son is a very strange Pirates fan. We've always agreed to be Kaizer Chiefs at home. So we went to this soccer match one day with Sipho's kids. They were there. We had beautiful meals at the stadium there. And then when Pirates started scoring, my son just stood up and made crossed hands and looked at me, saying, "Dilipaganiya, daddy." And I didn't know that. So I discovered it on that day that my son actually is a Pirate until today. So I would not say I know Sipho very long, but for the time that I've known him, it's been profound. I've come to know a few people like Isaac as well, and Andrew, and... Am I talking elsewhere? Sorry. So I'm sharing this with you because for the times that I've journeyed with him, it's been profound. I remember that the MC hosted me on the day of the celebration of the years of marriage and so on, with buying and sharing of rings on that day that I participated in. He was extremely late. He was so late that I arrived there and he came 3 hours later. And so we couldn't ask the wife to come because the husband wasn't there yet. So we had to wait and make sure that we make sure that he comes first before Tio arrives. But she was always been ready to arrive, but he was just late. And we had to embrace him. That's the kind of personality, the gentleness, the easiness he has to flow with him. I've come here today to share with you my own very own pain and journey about his passing. And one thing that stands out for me is the following, is that the Spirit prays on our behalf when we are weak. I know, and that's a text in Romans chapter 8, verse 27. When we are weak, the Spirit prays on our behalf. I know many of you have good questions to ask, but why do God take such a wonderful man from us? Why do God have to choose him? The question really is it God who does that? Or is it not the fact that the day we were born, we were also determined when to die? It's difficult to see pain caused by God, because we know God to be a God of love, a God of forgiveness, a God of care. Many years ago, when I was a priest in Khayelitsha, in the late 90s, I had discovered that a young girl was burned herself in the shack. And everybody in the community said, but it was God's will for that to happen. And I stood up and said, but no, it is not God's will. Because I understand God to be a God of love, a God of mercy. But what I said that day, had her mother not being forced to work and sleep in elsewhere to provide for her kids, the child wouldn't have died. Because the mom had to go and go to work, sleep in for weeks and come on weekends. During the week, the kids were left to fend for themselves, to make food, to light up the flame, which exploded. That is not what I understand God's will to be. That God is the God of love and remains to be a God of love. And the proof is this, that when we are weak, he brings us a support structure. He brings us that support that we need to walk through this journey. The only healing to pain is to honor the pain. When we postpone the suffering, when we postpone the moment to embrace our pain,
It is then that we delay our healing. We only heal when we embrace fully this experience. Accept it. Don't wrestle with it. Don't question it too much. Embrace it, because the answers you are looking for will not come. But embracing it means, as Paul teaches us, that the body is weak. The body is weak. It's made to decay. It's made to be destroyed. The body is so weak it cannot stand. It is not meant to be an eternity experience. But the spirit is renewed. There's an identity we share that can never be tarnished. There is an identity we have that cannot be removed or taken from us. In the beginning, in Genesis, there's a wonderful experience we learned about. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. When God breathed into us, the Bible says in Sesotho, Rabam moya opirang. Eseng tobo zifela. Rabam moya opirang. When God breathed into us, we became a living spirit. So when the body, Sipho dies in the physical body, he still lives in the spirit. We should not be confused by when we miss his voice, when we miss his perfume, when we miss his encouragement, when we miss his leadership, then we automatically conclude, ufilu Sipho. His actions were not just physical. He left a presence emva. He was something to remember. He left an act for you to find your way to healing. This is not a hopeless case. This is not the end of the story. He's dead in flesh, but alive in the spirit. Oh, people have always asked, but who are we? God says we are made in his image. And I've also struggled with that for a long time. Because the image of God to me was like, as a young boy, I used to look at my nose. I say, I got this big nose. God must be having my big nose. Then I look at the other person who's got a flat nose. Then I ask, but how can God have all these noses at the same time? Because the image of God is not the body. The image of God is not your outer appearance. The image of God is the spirit. That is the image of God. Not that which we look like. And when we got scars. Because the body, as you see, this outer body, it represents, is the face too. Lento engapheliyo ephila ngaphakathi kwethu. So the truth and the good news is this. Wathi uYesu, Jesus said this to his disciples, especially Mary when she came to the tomb, or why do you look for me among the dead? Because waphila. I think it's supposed also to say to you that what confuses us many times about death is because we sometimes say pass away and pass on. We use these two words interchangeably. But I want to put to you as a fact so that you realize ewe umzimba uyachabalala kodwa umoya wona uyaphila. That's why when we say pass away, we mean umzimba uphelile iyaphela. But when we say pass on, yes, he lives forth. Mamela, my friend. Mamela, please, young man. You're going to hear him. You will stand in front of a mirror. You look at yourself and you will smile. Listen to me, young girl. You will hear him in a phone call that is long past. You'll read a message, can you mean? And it will sound as if he just wrote it. Matthew, don't be strong for your children. You can take care of themselves. Be strong for you. Be vulnerable so that you can experience the healing. Without vulnerability, there's no healing. Without acknowledging that you are broken, there's no healing. We begin by acknowledging our brokenness. There's a good news story that I want to tell you. Because God breathed into us, we became a living spirit, not a living human being, but a living spirit. There's good news here today. And that good news is that, as Peter writes and teaches us, he says, we have an inheritance that is incorruptible. Nothing can corrupt our heritage from God. Not death, not suffering, not sickness. Nothing, absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. He set you an example, and I know this well because I was there. When he spoke about his mom, he spoke so much about great joy. Please remember, for you to heal, to remember the joy your father left for you. Don't just feel it because you can't have the bike anymore. You can't have the best shoes anymore. But remember, all these gestures are memories that will help you through life. All the things he did is literally to leave you with milestones you can refer back to. He was a wonderful man. Tick. He was a wonderful man. Tick. Every step of the way, what you're going to now, he has prepared you for it. There are lots of absent fathers who can't be located. Your dad had an address. Your daddy, you could reach him whenever you needed him. Don't cry like a child next door who does not have the examples you have. Other wives don't know where their husbands are. Other wives don't know where their husbands are buried. Other wives just waswelegalanto. But you have the privilege to say, my dear loving husband, thank you for the memories. May this word give you comfort. May they give you healing. The journey is long, and it's going to be long. But remember, the one who brought the pain will also bring the healing. Remember, the one who brought you the pain will bring you the healing. Remember, the one who decided to die. It's going to be difficult for my children. But he will also come back and bring you the healing. Just don't focus too much on missing his physical person. Then you will not connect with his spiritual person. The problem is sometimes grieving is we're stuck around. We are so concerned about what kind of clothes was he wearing? What kind of smells he was carrying? How his voice sounded like? And then we are less concerned to discover this man who brought us the pain to also bring us the journey to find the healing. You will be a good father, my boy. You will be an excellent dad. I'm telling you, because you have had an excellent father. You'll be an excellent mother, children who don't have kids, because you've seen excellent parents carrying out their commitment to each other. You cannot be lost with such examples of father and mother. You cannot be grieving as if there's no hope. You should grieve because the examples are right in front of you. You will be good, and I'm looking forward to seeing you being good. You'll be excellent. You'll be a good support to your mother. You all will be great support. Children are a gift from God. Children are a gift from God, Matthew. God gave you the gift. And God knew this day was coming. But he knew also in that child, his true greatness that will live beyond him. God, who brought the pain through your husband's passing, will also bring you the tools to carry through. Just be alert. Alert to your journey. And may the showers of God be bestowed upon you in true blessings. Let us pray. Ribine Hosanna. Hosanna. Ribine. Morena, Morena, Matata, Morena, Morena, Lise. Ribine, 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 oh, Hosanna, Hosanna, Mahudi, Hosanna, Hosanna. Let us pray. Sipho, may the Lord, may the angels lead you into paradise. Sipho, may the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choir of angels welcome you where Lazarus is poor no longer. May you have eternal rest, O give rest, O Christ, to your servants with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing nor but life everlasting. You are only immortal, the creator and maker of all, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to the earth we shall return, as you ordained when you created us, saying, dust you are, to dust you shall return. We all go down to the dust, and weeping at the grave, we make our song, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, now you let your servant Sipho go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. Our own eyes have seen the salvation which you prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations on the glory of your people Israel. Amen. We are now listen to the directions and announcements, and thereafter we proceed to the cemetery. We'll say the benediction and the blessing at the cemetery. Thank you.
Uyalalelwa noma isimo singavumi uyalalelwa uyalalelwa. Somanda so ada nami simono mai simo sina fumi si na fumi ogulalela
hallelujah. Bazalwane sesishiwe isikhathi by 3 minutes. I have urgent announcements, and I'm hoping even those that are on the streets can hear me. We know that Usipho was a man of order. He was a man that followed the law and all the rules that government has set. We need you to do the same. Standing around with your friends, keep social distancing. Whether you are inside Emagcekeni akathanjekwayo or you are in the streets, you are representing abakathanjekwayo. Keep your mask on and keep social distancing and don't gather too much. It has been reported to the authorities. We do not need that. Amen. Secondly, please do not drink on the streets. It is not allowed. Lastly, there are no after tears gatherings allowed. Amen. Keep your mask on, social distance, no alcohol, do not gather. With that being said, I'm going to read out the names of the people that will be accompanying the Tanjewayo family to the cemetery to lay him in his last home on this side of glory. We will continue to stream on these screens what is happening at the cemetery. If you are not inside the gates, we ask you that we have already provided ready food packs that has been freshly cooked in a COVID safe environment, that you take the pack and you take home. So we're asking that the streets be clear as soon as possible. We need to do that because the gathering is only meant to be 2 hours, a maximum of 50 people. So we need you to please take the food we have prepared for you, and please may you proceed home and continue to watch online. Sanela. Amen. There will be a count when we get to the gate at the cemetery. You will be counted as you drive in. Please allow us not to have any drama go gating so that we can proceed and do as the man that we are taking there did everything. The names are Kimama Tiego, Mam Tanjewayo, Khunsi, Sebi, Mbali, Liano, Sichaba, Jabu, Amanda, Andy, Katso, Sili, Litabo, Idu, Malume Jabu, Zeya, Mamo, Tandi, Babili, Gonko, Zodwa, Isaac, Wilson, Thomas, Debucho, Tabang, Andrew, myself, Nokolo, Ntlantla, Dr. Sugan, Refilwe, Mamukhulu, Mamane, Ntate Mukhulu Tiny, Kabelo, Malume, Mampo, Thomas Security, Ntate Joseph, Ntate Pete, Lungi, Udi, Lebu, Lucky. From the Department of Comms, Hiki Honorable Mama Faith, Honorable Sizayele, Honorable Yoliswa, Mpo, Thomas Ntlantla, Tami, Kosnati, and the crew, in terms of camera crew, as agreed with the people that you are working with. The limit is 50 at the gate at the cemetery. Please do not go in and proceed and exclude those that are on the list by you doing so. Those are the admin that I need to say. And then the last admin thing, those that are going to West Park Cemetery, you will receive food upon return. Even that food, we ask you, 99% of you, if you may take the food and depart. It is tough times. We all like to linger and comfort. However, it is against the rules, the regulations, and the law of the time and the climate that the country is in. All the pallbearers are ready. Pardon? Please make sure you sanitize before you are there.
Shall we proceed?
We have the family to come and help assist to carry the flowers, the children, if possible.
No, I'm using this one.
Lenyamazan iyoles lalel lenyamazan lenyamazan iyoles lalel lenyamazan.
I am the resurrection, I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer lives, and that in the end he will stand upon the earth. I myself would see him with my own eyes, I and not another. Do not bring your servant into judgment. For you, for no one living is righteous before you. I am sure neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. We brought nothing into the world, we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. None of us lives for himself, and none of us die to himself. If we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. Eye has not seen nor ear heard, nor the heart of man conceived what God has prepared for those who love him. We believe that Jesus died and rose again. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so will be for those who died as Christians. God will bring them to life with Jesus. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Comfort one another with these words.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, I am the resurrection, I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer lives, and that in the end he will stand upon the earth. I myself will see him with my own eyes. I and not another. Do not bring your servant into judgment, for no one living is righteous before me. I am the resurrection. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Let us pray. Almighty God, your Son, Jesus Christ, by his burial sanctified the grave to be a bed of hope to your people. Bless this grave, that it may be a resting place, peaceful and secure, for the body of your servant Sipho, for the sake of him who died and was raised and is alive forevermore. Amen. In the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Sithina la kahle wena dlamane lihle nina nidlani buyise ngaphansi kwekaba mina buyisa ngaphezulu kwenkaba niyatshokoza nina amadlamana amahle bomvemve wenyoni dlamane lalangocolo.
put. The flower.
The flower.
All right. I don't want man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who is justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pain of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer, forgive our sins, and at the last hour, let us not fall away from you. Most gracious mercy and protection, we have entrusted our brother Sipho, and we now commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died, was buried, and rose again for us, to him be glory forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord henceforth. Blessed indeed, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor, for their deeds follow them. God will show us the path of life. In his presence is the fullness of joy, and at his right hand there is pleasure forevermore. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. We now give to the family an opportunity to do his last ritual or to show his last respect. If it's in the tradition of the family to throw soil, they must come forward now. We'll do that under a song or being directed by the person who coordinates the music. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Till we meet that Jesus. Coming for you and for me. Sipilu Dirobekile Mimoya Idubekile Impa Jehovah Ritsepile Ritsepile Wena Diputso Dinata Impa di Carlavo Tona di Nenyane Fela Jehovah Ritsepile Ritsepile Wena Runa Jehovah Ritsepile Alone Ritsepile Wena
Yeah.
thought, never stop to think. Oh, never stop to think. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We are now going to invite the representative of the family who's going to do the vote of thanks to come forward, please. And after that, we'll get directions and announcements on what's going to happen from here. And before you go, please just receive the final blessing after the announcements are made.
Hallelujah. Hello. Relebaha Tanje Kwayo Malinga. Lebaha Metsing. Ebaki Bahauteng, Rale Leboha. Rale Esra Naha Tanje Kwayo Leha Metsing. Inne Motokamuka. Rale Leboha Rere. Lefete Kwayo Tape Mazon Alimit. Ralebo.
The announcements is sizobuyela ekhaya kathanje kwayo la sisuke khona manje kuseni. For COVID-19 protocol purposes, the food is prepacked and ready for you to take. So if you can just drive through, take what we've prepared for you, ukuthi nisigeze izandla bese niyahamba. And then siyabonga ngicela manenza konke sikhumbule social distancing, no crowding, no hugging.
Please receive the final blessing as we disperse. The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Please go in peace to love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ. Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All protocol observed.